Hey, before I play this video, man, I gotta give major shout outs to Styles P and Cameron, man, for coming together like true men following that historic classic hip hop battle and showing what the true essence of hip hop is by the Locks. But them coming together as rumors start to swirl about Cameron doing this, like black men to kind of hush all the rumors, all the negative air stirring around this event, as these two groups look to go forward on and make money together, and hopefully to not make promoters and other financiers, you know, kind of wary about putting these two groups together, thinking there's high level tension behind them, like intelligent black men and representatives of this great art musical genre known as hip hop. They come together like true men inside of a juice shop, not a liquor store, inside of a juice shop owned by the business owner Styles P, and they speak and they have a great conversation here on the live from Styles P. This is elegant type shit in the way real black men speak like brothers. But check this shit out. That's the shit that should be highlighted. But peep this.
Yo. What's good, y'all? What's good, y'all? Let me tell y'all something, man. I had a long ass week. My right hip hurts, man. My right hip hurts, and my green outfit got fucked up. That wasn't a regular. That was ragged moan. It didn't cost a lot, but it cost, you know, it wasn't drippy, but I was feeling good about it. Like, it was ragged moan. I thought it was, I don't know, it was rag and bone. But then my hip hurt. I was on the plane, my hip hurt. And then talking about my brother kicked me, man. He kicked me hard.
No, what happened was, he tried to rip my whole pants leg off.
I did, I sat on a chair.
No, you ripped my whole pants leg off.
No, I sat on a chair, killer.
No, you ripped that. Look, I appreciate my drip. And he said that shit was $1,000. He tried to rip the whole pants leg off. And
I said,
No,
that Gucci shit off.
I didn't know what was going on.
I felt the kick on the head.
I did not know.
I said, Killer kicked me on the head.
Nah, stop.
Did he kick me again?
So then when you
said, I love Killer.
No, when you did that, I said,
I love Killer.
I said,
it's my brother.
Are we a Hulk Hogan and Randy Savage?
I thought we were getting chippy.
I thought we were Hulk Hogan and Randy Savage.
Early before the fight, I said, Killer, we getting chippy in there.
I didn't know how chippy was.
He said, we getting chippy.
I didn't know how chippy.
I said, 50% chippy. No Frankston.
Exactly.
Don't Frankston me.
That's a fact.
Don't punch me in my face, Killer.
That's a fact.
It's all good.
I didn't know what was going on.
He put his Gucci's on me. Then I looked at the shit. This nigga threw Gucci's on me.
I thought we was going, oh yeah, brother.
Tell you something, though. I thought I was Ric Flair, Savage, I thought I was everybody. This nigga came out in the beach shit.
Yeah.
You know what it was? When they said Harlem, they said Yonkers, hailing from Yonkers, Platinum. Hailing from Harlem, did set multi-platinum.
I missed all the introduction. When y'all see me, I walk. Shout out to my brother Fat Joe, but he got a little one. That's big bro. I love you, big bro. I didn't get in Madison Square Garden because they bum rushed the door. Until you see me walk in the ring, I missed the whole introduction. I missed the whole Harlem Yonkers shit. When y'all see me walk in the ring, that's when I first got there. So then when I sat down, the shit started, and I'm like, nigga try to rip my pants off me.
I wanted to tell people, I don't, you know, he didn't Frank stare me, he didn't snuff me. You said we was getting chippy.
I love
but let me tell y'all something. This is historical facts.
Not yet.
If I'm lying,
I bet.
If I'm lying, I'm flying.
That's a fact.
Before I got on, you know how I met this man? Mm-hmm. I met this man through murder. He harbored me as a criminal. I will always love Killer.
I love this
and
nigga.
I respect him as a businessman.
This is about 1996.
You know what I mean? That's he harbored me
95.
As a criminal from a shootout. You know what I mean? For a few days, I was fucked up. I was with Mace and Killer. I was in Harlem. I was in his house, murder's house. We was chopping it up.
That's a fact.
Everybody had an Avon Rex Young fellas, I don't know what Avery Rex is, but it was fire. But I love this man. So promoters.
All the promoters.
We are not beefing. Everybody out there. We will never beef.
We are not beefing.
We will never beef. And if we did beef, you would never see it because we love each other. It would be as men. Listen to me. We did it. We had a great time. We had a ball doing it. It was a beautiful night.
It's a fact.
But bigger than that, we are black entrepreneurs. Please do not get it twisted.
That's a fact.
Please do not get promoters. Do not get scared.
That's a fact.
Do not worry about it. We said that we were going to get chippy.
That's
we
fact.
Said we would give you the show of your lifetime,
yo,
and we
it.
Did.
That's
you
a
didn't
fact.
Think hip hop could give you a UFC, Dana White holler at us.
Yeah, that's a
you
fact.
Know what I'm saying?
Yes.
WWE, Vince McMahon holler at us.
That's a fact.
You didn't think hip hop and gutter hip hop can do that.
That's a
but
fact.
We could do that. We are smart. We are businessmen. We are entrepreneurs. Please, this is not Yonkers versus Harlem.
At all.
I love Jimmy.
At all.
I love Santana. I love this. We are not going to separate our culture.
At all.
We are black men, brown kings, trying to get richer and wealthier, and wealthier and healthier. We are juices for life.
Right.
We're talking all kind of shit. Prepare for what we're doing, but by no means will we let y'all control the narrative.
That's a fact.
Of what happened that night.
That's a
I
fact.
I love this man. I will
I love
always
this nigga
love
too,
him.
Man, for
I
you.
Will always
this
love him.
This is a real 25-year relationship.
This is real. This is fact. Bigger than what happened in the garden. All of that. I respect him. And watch out for us, man.
Yeah.
For promoters.
Please, we are not beefing. All
please.
The promoters.
Please.
We are going on tour. Hero tour. We are not beefing. No
not promoters. At all. Please.
At all.
We just wanted to give y'all something different.
At all.
We wanted y'all to know New York City, 90s babies, really 70s babies, 80s babies, are different.
That's
and we
fact.
Love this.
That's
we could get
fact.
Chippy, we could bump each other.
Yes.
It's like a basketball mm-hmm. game. That's what New York City is about.
Super
we
super
just wanted
right.
to bring it back for y'all.
Facts.
I hope y'all understand this. Please, every promoter in the world, understand we love each other.
Facts.
You know what I'm saying? It's bigger than what you know. We got Chippy. Our energy was up, but we explained that to each other before we got there.
True.
So it is our humble duty to not let y'all control the narrative.
That's a fact.
We must control it. Don't. We all want to win every time.
That's a fact.
I never want Kiss a Cheek to have a better verse than me.
Right.
Let alone them niggas. That's just how we do.
That's competitive nature, though.
That's my nature.
That's
that
competitive
is all of
nature.
Our
nature. That's the way it is.
Do not get it confused.
From, listen. Not to cut you off.
Go ahead.
We born in the 70s, but we grew up in the 90s. If you watch any basketball shit in the 90s, football shit, niggas is not cool when it's time to compete. Before and after, niggas is cool. When it's time to compete and get on that floor, you are not cool. Michael Jordan, Charles Barkley are not.
Yeah, they
cool.
was elbows.
Yeah, they beat each other
yeah.
up.
See, a lot of, you know what it is? The 2K babies never seen nobody get elbows.
Yeah, them niggas is all cool by y'all and all that.
Can you help me out? You know what hurt me the most, though?
What's that?
What
I'm
me.
Listening.
Can you help me this?
I'm
help
listening.
Me with this?
Mm-hmm.
Kevin Durant hurt me on this one.
Nah, what you got? That's a bro. That's bro.
I know he loves y'all more. That hurt. I wanted to cry, man.
Listen, man.
I argued for this nigga when he left Oklahoma.
Okay.
He left.
That's the bro.
I wanted to cry. Kevin Durant, I love you. Almost baby. Kevin Durant.
Kevin,
you made me.
Listen, Kevin.
You gave me the glory one single.
You did the right thing.
You gave me the one. You gave me the glory one tear, Kevin Durant.
Don't fight for him more than me. That's my bro. You crazy, nigga. That's my
I don't know, Kevin.
Let me tell you something.
I argue with friends.
Let me tell you something.
I said.
No, but.
Boy.
LeBron gave y'all the props after the show.
He did?
Yeah. You got
but I argued in the hood over Easy Money Sniper.
That's over
LeBron.
We're not going with that.
I almost cried.
Easy Money Sniper.
But anyway, promoters, New York City, gangsters, businessmen, entrepreneur, business people, or everybody watching. We are businessmen.
That's
we are here.
That's a fact.
Cut us in or cut it out.
That's a fact.
That's fucking it.
We
know how to bullshit.
It's not no beef on tour.
Yeah.
It's not a problem. We love y'all niggas, man.
We love y'all. We're going to see y'all later. Mm-hmm. You know what it is. Mm-hmm. Dipset, D-Block, New York City for life. Don't cut our fucking money out. We love y'all, and I love my brothers. Until it's over.
Webby. Big horsepower too, nigga.
Bang, bang, bang. See y'all later. You know what it is. Promoters hit us back. Get it right. You know what it is. I got Killer in the juice bar, and we're gonna make him pick up a few fruits and vegetables, and you can come get the Killer juice tomorrow.
Huh?
Love is love.
Love is
yeah.
Love. You gotta save that one. Send me that.
Yeah. Got to appreciate them. You gotta set it right. Just set it true.